Hey everyone! Today, I'm going to show you how to make your video files smaller on Linux, so they take up less space. This way, you can easily upload videos to YouTube, or share them via email. However, I'd advise against sending large video attachments in emails. I have two similar-looking videos side by side, but one is a whopping 728 megabytes, while the other is just 53 megabytes. The secret behind this difference? A highly efficient compression algorithm. Let's explore how you can use this technique on Linux to reduce your video sizes. To get started, we'll install a free and open source video transcoder called Handbrake. Handbrake offers a lot of features, including video resizing, cropping, and rotation. It's a versatile tool. Before installing Handbrake, it is essential to update your Linux system. To update your system, run the following commands: sudo apt-update, sudo apt-upgrade. This ensures all existing packages are up to date, preventing any conflicts during installation. Handbrake is available in the default repository, making the installation process straightforward. However, the version in the default repository may not always be the latest. To install Handbrake using the default repository, execute the following command: sudo apt install handbrake. Another option for installing Handbrake is using the popular package manager Flatpak. Click to launch the app. I have an individual video file taking up 728 megabytes that I want to shrink. Select the open source button to select the video you want to open. Right up above, you'll see your video file name, and this is now referred to as the source. This is the file that we are going to transcode. Down below, you'll see several different tabs, and each one of them has many different available settings, and we can use these to reduce the video file size. If you're not comfortable tweaking these settings, Handbrake offers presets for common use cases, like reducing the video size for email attachments, or optimizing it for a specific device. If you choose a preset, you're good to go. I'll select the default setting Fast 1080p and explain some of the key settings. Right up here, you can choose the format, and you'll probably recognize some of these containers. I'll select MP4. On the Dimensions tab, you can flip a video. You can also rotate or crop a video. Here in the middle, you can also adjust the resolution. And if you lower that, fewer pixels will make up your image, which can help you save some space. Lastly, you can also add a border to your video. Moving on to the next tab, there's one called Filters, and here you have a number of different options. Once again, you can hover over them to see what they do. One of the more interesting options, down at the very bottom, you can turn your video into grayscale or basically black and white. The Video tab, for instance, lets you choose between H.264 and H.265 encoding. H.265 generally provides better quality with a smaller file size. However, some platforms might not support it yet, so be mindful of where you'll be using your video. You can choose the frame rate, and this is how many still images appear every single second in your video. I'm going to select same as source. It's advisable to use constant quality and set your desired quality level. Higher quality means a larger file, and vice versa. So if you want high definition content, here they recommend between 20 and 23. I'm going to select 23. You can also set the encoder speed. The more time the encoder has, it can ensure better image quality and also smaller file size. Moving on to the next tab, we have audio. And here, just like with video, you can choose the codec for your audio. I'll leave it set to the default of AAC. In general, audio has a pretty minimal impact on the overall file size. So, I'll leave these set as is. Lastly, you can also adjust the subtitles and the chapters. If you've customized your settings and want to use them again in the future, you can save them as a new preset. This can save you time down the road. Handbrake includes a preview. When you click on that, it'll show your video and you could just encode, say 15 seconds of it. You can then view it to see if you're satisfied with it. Once you're satisfied with your settings, choose where you want to save the file. Hit Start Encoding. You'll see a progress bar, and when it's done, your video file should be significantly smaller with comparable quality. If you wish to stay updated on my posts or receive other Linux news, please subscribe to the WhatsApp or Telegram channel. The links can be found in the description. Let me know in the comments if you successfully reduced the file size of your video. If you'd like more Linux videos like this, please consider subscribing. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.